Hello everyone, I'm Tim from Tim Does Level Design, and welcome to Lesson 1 of my beginner course in video game level design. We're going to be covering a lot about what the many facets of level design are, but instead of just talking about the theory of it, I'd like you to put things into practice as soon as possible, having fun with it as we learn step by step. However, this does mean we'll have to get some boring setup stuff out of the way first. So, first things first. We're going to be working with Unreal Engine 5. I've chosen Unreal Engine because it's one of the most widely used game engines alongside competitors such as Unity and Godot. A game engine like Unreal Engine is a software framework that allows us to make use of a lot of out-of-the-box functionality and development tools, so we can focus a lot more on the level design aspects of development rather than spend too much time on elaborate technical setup. So, to get to work, let's set up the engine first. Open up your internet browser of choice and search for Download Unreal Engine. Clicking on what for me is the first result will end up on unrealengine.com. As the website tells us, to install Unreal Engine, we'll need to install the Epic Games Launcher first. If you don't have it installed yet, let's click the download button to download the Epic installer and run it when it's finished downloading. When we've installed the launcher and opened it up, it will ask us to sign in. If you don't already have an Epic Games account, there's a sign-up link at the bottom of this screen. When we're logged in and have the launcher open, we're first greeted with the Epic Games Store. You may be asked to install Epic Online Services, for which we'll press OK. This should be done after a short while, and we'll get a little Install Successful pop-up. We're currently not very interested in the Epic Games Store, but just want to get to the game engine. So let's select Unreal Engine from the left bar, which brings us to the Unreal Engine landing page. For now, we can ignore all this and click on the Library tab at the top of the screen. This is where we can find our installed versions of Unreal Engine, as well as any projects and downloaded assets from the marketplace, such as environments, dressing props, VFX, or entire projects. To get Unreal Engine installed, let's click on this yellow plus button. By default, it's ready to install the latest version, which at this time of recording is Unreal Engine 5.4.2. If you would like to install an older version of the engine, you could click the drop-down button and select the previous version of the engine. Though for this course, I've opted to use the latest version of Unreal Engine 5, as I would like the workflow shown in this course to remain as up-to-date as possible for as long as possible, and avoid teaching you outdated methods and tools where possible. As you likely live in the future, it's safest to select 5.4.2, as the project is definitely compatible with that, and we shouldn't run into any issues. The downside of this is that the absolute minimum specs you'll need to run this version of Unreal Engine on Windows are a quad-core Intel or AMD 2.5 GHz or superior processor, 8 GB of RAM, and any DirectX 11 or 12 compatible graphics card. But in practice, you'll need something beefier than that to run things smoothly, especially in terms of CPU and GPU. I'm really sorry if you currently don't have a machine that can run the engine and project, but although this series will work best if you can follow along on your machine, I'll try to structure it in a way that there's still as much value as possible to simply sit in, watch and listen to the rest of the lessons. Now, onwards with the engine setup. Let's click Install and select our install location. The more space you have available on the drive, the better. The full install, plus plugins and prerequisites, may take up over 130 GB of space on your machine, and it will likely take some time to download. But while you're waiting on the engine to install, you're more than welcome to watch some of my other level design videos on my YouTube channel. When the engine is installed, we can press the yellow launch button to open up Unreal Engine. If this is your first time opening the engine, you might have to install some prerequisite files, but this shouldn't take all that long. When Unreal Engine has opened up, we're greeted with the project browser window, from which we can create a new project or open up an existing one. We'll want to use the 2D platformer project I have prepared for this course, but we're going to have to download that project first. For now, let's close the Unreal Project Browser and navigate to the Google Drive link which I've added to this video's description below. Download the zipped project, and choose a download location. When it has finished downloading, unzip the folder. Now let's open up the Epic Games Launcher again. Before we open the project, to handle 2D sprites and animations in creating this prototype, I made use of a free engine plugin called PaperZD. To be sure everything in the project works properly, let's install this as well. Navigate to the Marketplace tab, and in the search bar type in PaperZD. Go to its page and click Install to Engine. With the installation done, we're now ready to open up the project. To double check that the plugin is installed to our engine version, in the Library tab, you can press the Installed Plugins button underneath our engine version 5.4.2. And there, we should be able to see PaperZD. Now we're ready to press the yellow launch button to open the engine. When the Unreal Project browser is opened, select the Recent Projects tab, and at the bottom of the browser, click the Browse button to navigate to the project location, which is where we unzipped the project earlier. In the Project folder, select the ActionRPG2D_LD_uProject file and press Open. It will take a little while to open the project, especially for the first time, as it needs to load all the project assets into memory. But after a bit of loading, we'll finally have the engine and project open, and we're ready to go. The biggest window open is called the Level Viewport, and functions as a window into the worlds that we're creating, and is a universal element that we'll encounter in almost any game engine or level editor software. The tab here on your top left over the viewport should read Map_SelectionScreen, as I've configured this level to be the default one to be loaded on startup. If for some reason you do not have this map opened up by default, we can open it manually. Let's press the Content Drawer button in the bottom left. This is where all the assets live that together make up our project, and this includes our maps. From the overarching content folder, double-click the Maps folder to open it up, or select it from the left-hand window. Here you'll see the level file called Map_SelectionScreen. Double-click this to open it into our viewport. One of the cool things about Unreal Engine is that we can play and test our content directly in the engine. In the main toolbar, right above our level viewport, we find a green play button. When we press this, it starts our gameplay simulation. To activate the window and detect our inputs, we need to first click in the viewport with our mouse. We can now press the left and right arrows on our keyboard to move, and the Z key to jump. I also added controller support for this game prototype, so feel free to plug in and use, for example, an Xbox controller to playtest. I've only tested with an Xbox controller, though in theory, it should support different types of gamepads. To gain back control of our mouse, we can press Shift+F1. Now we can press the Stop Simulation button in the main toolbar. Hovering over the Play button, we see that we can use the shortcut Alt+P to start the simulation. The stop button indicates that we can press escape to stop the simulation. While working on your level designs, it's very important to test things frequently, so I recommend remembering these shortcuts. So, in the selection screen, you can walk into any of the map transition boxes to load up the levels specified within. For testing the demo levels, you should walk into the first one in the top left, as the next demo level is loaded when you reach the end of the current one. When you press number 1 in your keyboard, you load back into the map selection screen, and all progress is lost. Okay, we should be all done with the setup now, and this concludes the content of lesson 1. But like we'll do in future lessons, I'll give you a bit of homework to complete before starting the following lesson. Now, it's impossible to make good levels for a game that you do not fully understand. So today's homework is to play the 4 demo levels through to the end. It's not required to take any notes, but feel free to do so if you feel it's useful to remember specific bits about the project, like enemy behavior or various interactive elements you encounter in the demo levels. Now, if you're not able to play through the demo levels for whatever reason, whether your PC can't run it or you get stuck somewhere, I will upload a full playthrough video for you as an addendum to this one. It should be the next one up in the playlist, but I'll also link it in the description below. And that concludes the first lesson of my beginner course in video game level design. It would be very nice of you if you could like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and turn on the notification bell to be informed when my next video is uploaded. Thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next video.